Each year, more than 4,000 people are badly burned when flames from commonly used items suddenly explode, shooting fires several feet through the air. This morning, WJZ investigates. Mary Bubala tells us how two mothers whose daughters were severely burned want to prevent this from happening to anyone else.
It's a phenomenon that turns everyday household items into dangerous, even deadly flamethrowers. It's called flame jetting, and it can happen with flammable liquids like the gasoline you use for your lawnmower, fireplace fuels, and even liquor. When the containers get near an open flame, the fumes can ignite, engulfing everything in their path. It happened to Baltimore County native Aubrey Clark.
It was like
In 2011, Aubrey was just 17 at a party with friends when one got close to an outdoor fire with a gasoline can. Aubrey was more than 10 feet away, but flames enveloped her, burning a third of her body. Tanya Clark describes for WJZ her daughter's devastating injuries.
Her chest, neck, face, her arms, her hands were all burned.
As a mother who nearly lost her child to flame jetting, Tanya is not alone. Margaret Lewis's daughter was also severely burned. She and her twin sister were roasting marshmallows.
The fire had gone out after about 20 minutes, and they went to refuel it. When I heard this screaming and I ran outside, I saw my daughter on fire, like a fire log.
Margaret and Tanya tell WJZ every year in the U.S., nearly 4,000 people are burned and 450 die from common household products that explode and unexpectedly shoot fire through the air, sometimes 5, 10, or 15 feet.
You have the evidence. You have the victim.
We need action.
And they're taking their fight all the way to Washington, D.C. A new bill introduced by California Congressman Mike Thompson and backed by Maryland Representative Dutch Ruppersberger would require manufacturers to put metal or plastic screens on flammable liquid containers. They are known as flame arrestors, which block the fumes from escaping.
All we're trying to do is to protect people from the gas vapors that come out and they ignite, and then all of a sudden it causes a lot of damage to human beings.
We want these defective products to be made usable. It shouldn't be a bomb. If we put the protective barrier, the safety guard, back at the opening, 100% of the time they're safe to use. Who would sell a product that becomes a flamethrower or a bomb?
Mary, this flame jetting is just so dangerous.
I know, and it's something none of us have really heard of before until you see what we just saw.
Right, and why is it taking so long to solve this problem, to fix it?
Right, which we just saw, there's such an easy fix, but there's a pretty powerful lobby against this group of moms for whatever reason, but they are really determined to really get to these manufacturers, get legislation passed, so this easy fix is now standard. And there is, though, I should mention, a way that you can do at home. You can buy these flame arrestors, the screens, on places like Amazon.com. They are pennies to the dollar. You can actually go look at everything in your household, the products, and make them safe yourself while we wait for the manufacturers to actually make the change.
That's good to know. So how are the victims in your story doing today?
I know. These lovely, lovely young women, they are actually doing really well, and both their moms wanted that really to be mentioned, that they are moving on with their lives. One is out of college. The other one is just finishing her freshman year of college. But they are both burn victims, and burn victims never truly, really 100% recover. So they both have surgeries, they both have therapy, and you know, that's always going to be with them. So it's really, really tragic.
Something they'll have to deal with their whole lives.
Yeah.
It's worth repeating just how many people are injured.
I know, since this is sort of a new phenomenon to a lot of us, it is 4,000 people are injured by this flame jetting, which is just such a random, crazy thing that happens. And hundreds die from it every year. They die from flame jetting. So it's really, really important that we get the word out, people educate themselves, and then until they get the screens or the flame arrestors, as we call them, you just have to be very careful.
I've never heard of this. You've really opened my eyes, Mary. Thank you. And we'll be right back after this. It's WJZ.